You're back. Oh, I'm so excited to see you again. Come here. Give me a big hug. Gosh, it's so nice to see you again. Wow, and you even came all the way up to my den. That's amazing. I remember last time we met, you had all those little magic artifacts with you. You were starting to learn how to use them, right? I bet you must be a master of magic by now. A witch for the ages. You probably, I don't know, teleported or something to get all the way up here, right? Oh, you hiked. Well, that is actually pretty impressive too. That might actually be even more impressive, considering the fact that this is not a small mountain. I would have picked someplace lower and much easier to get to, but this is the only cave around here that I'll fit in. Well, I mean, when I'm like whoosh, big and all lizardy looking, I know I look pretty human right now, but I can transform too. Most of us non-humans can. I think that surprises a lot of people. I'm not sure if it was an adaptation, or if maybe everything started out human and kind of went in separate ways, but it's interesting to think about. I think so, anyway. I even know a couple sea monsters who can get out and get on two legs and look vaguely human-ish. One of them glows in the dark a little too much to totally pass, but it's super adorable, honestly, so it doesn't even matter. Dragons are old, but we don't have kids very often. There are less generations of us than I think you might expect. So maybe that's why we can only look mostly human. We haven't had as much time to evolve or something. I don't know. Oh, wow. I got way off track. I am so sorry. My point was, gosh, it is so nice to see you again. I kind of lost control of my mouth, which happens more often than I would like to admit. So, anyways, come on in. I know it gets a little cold out here. I've got some furs and blankets and stuff I keep for visitors and friends when they stop by. You can put some of those on. I'll make a fire and get you all set up, okay? And get you comfy. Oh, and now that you're here, I can show you my hoard. Gosh, I didn't tell you about that before, did I? Oh, you'll love it. It's so much fun. You've never seen one, right? Well, okay. I don't want to get your expectations too high. Mine is maybe not the best. And it's not huge or anything. And honestly, people always kind of give me weird looks when they find out what I like to collect. No, it's nothing weird or bad. I don't know. But hear me out, okay? Anyway, when you see it, just remember that I am barely a century old, so you can't expect too much out of me just yet, okay? Give me a few centuries. I'll really wow you. Oh, why are you looking at me like that? I swear, I'll show you. Give me just a couple 100 years. I'll show you how. Yes. I am so sorry. Is that, are you sensitive about that? Like, you guys in general, the whole only living for like a century thing. I mean, it's not, don't get me wrong, it's not bad. It's not bad that it's short. Length isn't everything. That's a saying you guys have, right? That life is about quality, not quantity. It's not about the length. It's how you use it. That's a. Oh, what? Why are you laughing? What's so funny? That's a saying, right? Or did I mix them up again? Oh, it just doesn't mean that. What does it mean? Okay, but you have to tell me before you leave, okay? Well, I'm glad I could make you laugh. Even if I had to say something stupid to do it. It was worth it. Your laugh is nice. It makes me happy when other people are happy. And I think I especially like it when you're happy. So I guess I'll just have to work hard to make my hoard nice and grand that much faster so you can be totally impressed that much sooner. Okay. Come on. Follow me. It's just a little further in. Yeah, it's what it looks like. Buttons. Yes, buttons. All kinds of buttons. Big buttons. Small buttons. Plastic. Shells. Fuzzy buttons. They're my favorite. You guys like to decorate your clothing with them so much, and you always keep them close to you on your shirts and your pants. And well, I hardly ever see a human without some kind of buttons. So Well, it's kind of embarrassing to admit, but when I was little, I thought they must be something special. I figured everything else humans kept on them was something special, right? Like money. Humans always had money on them, and humans think money is important. And so if humans always keep buttons on them, well, I was young. I don't know, I guess it made sense in my head. I was too shy to talk to humans when I was just a young little baby dragon. So I would look at the stuff that humans liked, and I would look at the stuff they threw away, and just kind of watch from afar. Which actually sounds way creepier, saying it like that. So, just ignore that. Anyways. It was just a silly little thing that I thought when I was young. But there were so many different kinds of buttons. I just kind of started collecting them. Before I knew it, I had pockets full of them. And then I had a whole bag full of them. And then, before I knew it, I had my hoard. Or I started my hoard, at least. Dragons don't really choose what they hoard. I think people think that we make a conscious choice for it. Honestly, there are a lot of dragons that end up with strange hordes. It's just sort of in our nature to collect stuff, I guess. I mean, I can see why a dragon might collect gold and gemstones and valuable things. But I mean, honestly, a dragon with a hoard for something like that probably just likes them because they're pretty. Or because it's something shiny. We're not really much for the monetary value that humans put on things. I mean, for me, nowadays, I don't know. I really like the stories that come with buttons and the people that they were attached to. I like remembering where I've been and who I've met. I can remember for most of my buttons. But even the ones I can't, it's fun to imagine. I mean, if I'm being honest, it gets a little lonely up here. And sometimes just imagining people and creating whole lives for them just gives me a little entertainment. Look. Come here. See this one? It's huge and white and sturdy. And it looks like it would be right at home on a big winter coat. Maybe it belonged to some kind of traveler. Somebody who needed thick coats with big buttons to keep them closed during the winters. while they're going from land to land to peddle their wares. I like to come up with stories like that. What their name is, where they're from, and just make a life for them. Like I said, it gets a little lonely up here, so it keeps me entertained when I don't feel like flying all the way down to the village. It's fun to sort them, too, by color and by size, by weight and by feel, all that. It's actually even kind of fun coming up with new ways to sort them. Right now, I'm working on sorting them by how good I sleep when I put them under my pillow. I just take one every night and put it right under my pillow. It's not like they have any effect on how I sleep. Nothing like that. There's no magic or anything like that. It's just kind of arbitrary or fun, I guess. I mean, I've already explored all around these mountains, so I have time to kill. That's why I'm really happy that you're here. When people come and see me, it really means a lot to me, especially knowing everything I'm sure you had to do to get up here. That really means a lot. It does. And I appreciate you doing that. Especially when you guys, humans, I'm sorry. You guys sounds bad, but when you humans have so much stress, you work and you get anxious and you have to pay for everything. And I don't know. Don't get me wrong. Human life doesn't seem bad at all. I would love to have company like that, like you guys do all the time. But it seems like it can be stressful. Your whole way of life, I guess. I'm sorry if that sounds offensive. I'm just trying to say that the fact that you took time out of your life to come see me is just... whoa. This might be a little forward, but... well... I was just hoping... I was just wondering if you don't mind if I could have a button of yours to keep. Oh, sorry. Yeah, I know that's a weird question. Never mind. You can just ignore it. You don't have to. It was... Really? You don't mind? Oh, you really are the best. You know that. Thank you so much. You really are something special. And I don't want to forget you. Not not that I would or anything. I don't need a button to remember a nice face like yours. And it is a nice face. I've been told that humans worry about their faces and whether people like them or not quite a bit. But you don't have to, because you have got a great one. Lucky you. But I wouldn't forget you anyway, even without a button. It's just, it's nice to have something real and tangible to hold on to, you know? And I think if you're not here, and, you know, I miss you, it'll be nice to hold on to it. I can give you something too, if you want. I think dragon scales are supposed to be really useful for witches, but they also make really good armor. And some people say they're pretty, but that's totally up to them, I guess. So if you think it's ugly, you don't have to or anything, but you think my scales are pretty? I don't like to pick favorites. It just feels kind of mean, but don't tell anybody. But I think you're my new favorite person. You're so sweet. I've got to make sure and make an extra good meal for you tonight, okay? If you're planning on staying that long, anyway. Okay, good. And I can totally fly you down when you're ready. So you can stay all that extra time, okay? Have you ever flown before? It's amazing. I think you'll love it. I'm excited to see your first time in the air. It's like nothing else I can even think of. I mean, I'm not excited for you to leave. Just when you do, there's something to look forward to. How long do you plan on staying, if you don't mind me asking? Because you can totally stay as long as you want. I can show you where the best fruits are around here. And I can show you my top 10 favorite buttons. And I can tell you all about where they came from and stuff. Well, other than my newest favorite one, which sounded way more embarrassing out loud. Forget I said that, please. Thank you. You're the best. Now, come on. You've got to be chilly. Let's go get you some furs to warm up in. It's so nice to have you back.